the end of the day, Ms. McGuire was not convicted because of ineffective assistance on behalf of her trial attorneys. She was convicted because there's overwhelming evidence of her guilt. Her trial attorneys were able to get acquittals on 4 of the 8 charges. The fact that they couldn't get the grand slam and acquit her on everything doesn't mean they were ineffective. They did everything they could. They were outstanding for her. She not only got the minimal requirement for effective assistance of counsel, she got far beyond that. She got outstanding representation by 2 of the best trial attorneys that have come before a court in New Jersey. This court should recognize that and deny her request for an evidentiary hearing.
I would ask the court to not look at each case, at each issue individually, but as part of the context of the entire trial, because the state's case was a circumstantial case consisting of small individual points that should have each been attacked and challenged. And many of them were allowed to go unchallenged, unexplained, or went to the jury with half of the information. It's easy to say, well, you know, this wouldn't have made a difference, or that wouldn't have made a difference. But when you put it all together in a murder trial where the jury knows what's at stake and understands the definition of reasonable doubt, these many small issues taken together can mean the difference between victory or defeat.
Reviewed the matter, read the briefs, and what I'm going to do is give you guys a written opinion, which will be mailed to you next week, no later than Friday, 12:30. Thank you both for coming again.